Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to show you guys how did I measure the piston ring end gaps and how did I install the piston ring and some of the tips that you might want to hear when you are installing your pistons. First of all, we need to understand what is the function of piston rings. Alright, the piston rings, the main job is to seal off the combustion chamber so that the combustion gases won't be escaping down to the crankcase. Alright, so when it escapes to the crankcase, it will cause something we call blow-by gas. Especially, we can notice it when we open up the dipstick, the blow-by gas come up a lot. So much that it is like a choo-choo train. That means you are having too much of the end gap or too much of your blow-by gas. Alright, but the piston rings cannot be too tight as well. If it is too tight, then when the engine is hot, the water temperature is about 80 to 100 degrees, which is the operating temperature, the piston rings may expand and seize the piston or make your engine feel sluggish. Alright, so this is what we don't want, okay?
Hi guys, today I'm going to get the end gap of the piston ring. So I've already put oil and put the piston ring. Okay, this one I'm going to get the second one first, and then I'll remove them and then I'll get the first one. So I use a used piston and then try to put it onto the second ring so that I'll know the piston ring is totally horizontal. Okay, so I just push it, try to push it until I'm going to do the same to every piston ring. Have to be gentle because it is quite light. And then after that, I'm going to use my trusty feeler gauge to check whether the gaps are correct. But if it isn't, I'm going to file it down. Or first I'm going to do mix and match first, see whether I can get the correct one. If I can get, then I'll save my time on fouling the piston ring onto the correct gap. Alright, now we try to put in the first compression ring. Alright, this one is the most important one to seal the combustion chamber, all the compression, and prevent it to go through to the engine crankcase, so it will become blow by gas. So it's the same thing, we need to put in the piston ring first. Okay, I just put in very shallow. Alright, and then try to make it as shallow as I can. So I just use a piston to push it in. Okay, just nice I follow the first compression ring groove, and then that should be the place that the piston ring should be there.
Okay, remember that the piston rings has to sit horizontally into the block, into the engine block. Okay, why? If it is sit diagonally, the piston end gap might be differ slightly. That one you don't know. So you can either use a piston ring seater, or you can just use an old piston to just put in so that the piston ring is definitely horizontal and it is exactly at the piston first or the second compression ring or the oil ring. Okay, so this is This is a very easy way for you to make sure that the piston ring is seated horizontally.
Alright, I'm going to push it down. Oh, too much, I'm going to pull it up again. Okay, again. Oh. Alright, done. Okay, I'm going to measure the gap over here. Okay, as usual, I try to use the 0.5 mm to measure it first. If it doesn't fit, then it's good. I can use 0.4 to continue to measure. Alright. And then I'm going to measure everything and write down all the readings.
These readings, these measurements are of the original spec. Okay? If you guys are using aftermarket pistons such as CP, Manly, BC and so forth, you have to use their tolerances. Okay? Because they are using different material to manufacture the piston rings. So the expansion ratio, the heat expansion ratio is a little bit different with the original one.
Hi guys, I'm all prepared already. So I already cleaned up the holes here so that there is no impurities, so that when I put the corn rod bolt, so it won't, I can put lock tight so that it won't come off easily. And then I already prepared to put inside the piston and the corn rod. Alright, so a few key points that you need to know that is the crankshaft is rotating this direction, so that means the corn rod is moving like this. Alright, so mostly the piston slap, that means it is rubbing against the cylinder head, the cylinder ball is this side and this side. Alright, so when it rubbing this side, so the piston ring should be, the piston ring gap should be facing that side, so it will compress more. Alright, compress more and prevent the gas from leaking out. So always remember that the first piston ring, the top one, is at, if this point is pointing forward, this is the 12 o'clock. So this one should be the 3 o'clock. The second piston ring is 9 o'clock. The first oil ring is 7 o'clock. The oil ring expander is 1 o'clock, and then the bottom oil ring is at 11 o'clock. Alright, so if everything is all ready, we are set to go piston ring compressor. This one with a quick release, so I'm going to do the quick release. Pointing to the 12 o'clock. So we have to put this carefully. And make sure the crankshaft is pointing downward so I won't hit it anyway. Alright, this is also one mistake that I've done. I did not put in all the way the piston ring compressor. So
So one of the oil ring came out and then I had to do it again. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoy the series as much as I do. Please don't forget to subscribe if you guys think that this video series can help you. And I hope you guys enjoy too. See you!
Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video. And share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you!